The 20th century was one of violence and terror. The century was marked by major wars, regional conflicts, and various acts of terror. Advances in weapons technology caused terrorist attacks to spread to much wider areas. Terrorists are now able to cause the deaths of thousands of people with a single touch of a button. They can shape the course of world politics while remaining unseen. These attacks against countries regarded as the world's major powers show that no nation is any longer immune to terrorism. Unless precautions are taken against it, terrorism will come to represent an even greater threat in the 21st century. So, what is the solution to terrorism? We shall be looking at the answer to that question in this film. September 11, 2001. The United States of America. 8:30 in the morning. People going to work. Going about their daily business. These attacks against two great American cities showed us the latest level reached by terrorism. Because this terrorist attack was perpetrated against the world's only superpower at a completely unexpected time and in an unexpected way. In the days following the attack, there was an air of great fear and panic, the whole world over, particularly in America. However, this shock was swiftly overcome. And everyone began seeking an answer to the question, how are we to deal with terrorism? People realized they could face a terrorist attack at any time, anywhere. They realized that the aim of terrorism was to paralyze the life of society, to prevent people leaving their homes. In short, to create a society of fear. Terror is terror, no matter who commits it or how. The ruthless killing of thousands of innocent people in the World Trade Center. The poisoning of dozens of people in Japan. The targeting of innocent civilians in East Turkestan and Indonesia. The slaughter of more than 500,000 Hutus in Rwanda. The killing of defenseless people in Israel and Palestine. The loss of life inflicted by terrorist attacks in Turkey alone is of a terrifying dimension. Between August 15, 1984 and October 31, 2001, the number of terrorist attacks committed in Turkey was 21,866. 5,605 members of the security forces lost their lives. The number of civilians killed was 4,646. The total number of injured was around 24,000. Terrorism is not without a solution. Terrorism can be brought to an end by means of the elimination of its ideological infrastructure. The basis of this intellectual struggle consists of informing people about religious moral values. The love, affection, compassion, and tolerance these values impart will bring peace and security to the world. Terrorism chooses but one course of action to achieve its aims: acts of violence. In the mind of the terrorist, political disagreements and problems arising from ethnic and cultural differences can only be resolved by violence. Each group imagines it can only attain its objectives by ruthlessness and oppression. They claim that by these means they achieve right and justice. It is estimated that there are some 500 terrorist groups in the world. These include international criminal gangs that control the traffic in drugs, arms and prostitution, underworld organizations, perverted cults, and various radical groups that commit atrocities in the name of religion. In the present day, with the help of an experienced chemist, terrorists are capable of making a biological weapon that can threaten the lives of thousands of people. One of the earliest examples of this was the sarin gas attack on the Tokyo metro system in 1995. Twelve people died in this terrorist attack by a perverted cult, and 5,500 more were injured. Subsequent investigations reveal that this cult had sought to make biological weapons in its own laboratories.